Turkish diplomats throughout the world.
Un certain nombre de diplomates turcs à travers le monde.
Sanctions and trials followed, and I was called as a witness to several of these trials in France, Canada, and even in Holland. The acts were orchestrated by two different groups. A group belonging to the Dashnak party, calling themselves the Justice Commandos for the Armenian Genocide, who only attacked Turkish diplomats, and the Asala, a more complex group, as it was linked with more radical Palestinian movements. Al-Salah was fairly fragmented and had political overtones extending beyond the Armenian question. This group was responsible for intolerable acts, such as the bombing of Orly Airport in 1983, which killed several people, including Turkish nationals, when a bomb was thrown at the ticket office of a Turkish airline. The reaction was a general outcry, including from Armenians, and this type of criminal campaign was quickly ended. Armenian political activism again took the initiative with three events in 1984, 1985, and 1987, constituting a real policy change in the process of recognition of the Armenian genocide.
Qui constitue un véritable virage dans le processus de reconnaissance du génocide arménien.
April 1984, the Permanent People's Tribunal convened in Paris, based on the model of the Rossel Tribunals and founded by the Italian Lelio Basso, which, in the presence of several Nobel Prize laureates, recognized the Armenian genocide and the acts constituting the genocide. There was also a very moving incident when the Kurdish filmmaker Yilmaz Guni attended the tribunal just a few months before his death and made a statement in the name of his people, the Kurds, apologizing to the Armenians.
Car il était kurde, il demandait pardon aux Arméniens. Donc ça montrait,
if you like, this showed that a process of recognition could utterly change the order of the question.
La donne de cette question. Et puis le second élément a été la même.
Then the second factor was the same subcommission formed to study the Whitaker Report on genocide and which ended its deliberations in 1985 by finally agreeing to use the word genocide to describe the Armenian genocide.
L'inscription du mot génocide pour le génocide arménien dans ce rapport Whitaker.
This report was swiftly blocked and never left the subcommission stage, failing to gain recognition by the UN Commission.
Et puis ensuite,
the third factor was the work done by the Armenian organization in the European Parliament, agitating for a vote, passing the famous recommendation of June the 18th, 1987, calling on Turkey to make certain gestures, and in particular, to recognize the Armenian genocide, if it wished to become a member of the EU.
Et en particulier, la reconnaissance du génocide arménien.
As this was only a recommendation and not a precondition, these gestures never took place. But this recommendation was reflected in the conclusions of various European Parliament meetings up to 2004. The problem is first of all one of legacy. Turkey claims to be the heir of the Ottoman Empire, neglecting to point out that there are some 15 countries or nations that include several centuries of Ottoman history in their own history. They neglect to say this, and especially all the countries of the Middle East. But Turkey asserts itself as the heir of the Ottoman Empire. A legacy means taking all or nothing.
Ils opèrent un tri. Ils refusent un certain nombre de pages.
But Turkey is being selective here by denying certain shameful pages of their history, such as those dealing with the Armenian genocide. And there are reasons for this denial. I think that the first of these is an ethical reason. I mean that, having presented idealized view of Turkey in Ottoman history, in the made-up history of Turkey, and having painted the Turk as some sort of pure warrior, it is difficult to turn around and show him as the common murderer he was. The common murders that were the Ottoman troops, the young Turks and the people who took part in the massacres that constituted genocide. It is difficult to accept and to admit that for 90 years they deceived, manipulated and lied. It is not easy to go back. But there is another argument, that they were afraid to start a process which was bound to come about in any case. For my part, as a historian, I think that Turkey's recognition of the Armenian genocide should close the chapter. But many Armenians are not of the same opinion. They expect reparations, first of all, for all the injuries, and there are many, to their property and their money during this period and afterwards. They are also considering territorial claims, although less and less, because the Republic of Armenia, created in 1991, is clear on this issue, and I don't think that this will happen.
Est clair à ce sujet, à des revendications territoriales, mais je pense qu'il n'y en aura pas. Donc,
for the moment, I can't see how this recognition can be initiated, in as much as Turkey is not acting democratically in other areas, such as human rights, the Cyprus question, or other issues.
De façon démocratique dans d'autres domaines, comme celui des droits de l'homme, comme celui de Chypre ou d'autres problèmes.
Some Turkish historians do officially recognize the Armenian genocide, but for the most part, they are no longer in Turkey. The greatest modern Turkish historian is Tana Akşam, who is a remarkable historian. He lived for a time in Germany and is now in Minnesota. Worldwide, there are some Turks, particularly in the large Turkish community in Germany, who recognize the Armenian genocide. But historians and the academics working in Turkey blow hot and cold. And here, all the finesse and shrewdness of Ottoman diplomacy reflected in Turkish diplomacy is evident. Blowing hot, I mean that you hear historians who still hold positions in Istanbul or Ankara saying, yes, of course, there was genocide against the Armenians. In fact, one could call it proto-genocide. But not now. Wait until Turkey becomes a part of Europe. Wait until the Turkish people are ready to acknowledge this truth. This could be explained if it were not for those who blow cold. And by this I mean revisionism, taken to unimaginable lengths. First of all, they reverse the question. What is known in psychoanalysis as projection, where some in Turkey claim that there was indeed genocide, but that this was genocide of the Turks, perpetrated by the Armenians. Mass graves are dug up every now and then to support this hypothesis. Obviously Armenians' graves, but as these bodies, these skeletons, have no particular history of their own, it is not difficult to describe them as Turks killed during 1918, the period during which bands of Armenians and Russian army pushed into eastern Anatolia.
Des bandes arméniennes et de l'armée russe en dans l'est de l'Anatolie.
One does have to admit that massacres did take place by the Armenians in Turkish villages, but if you count the numbers, and it is important to do so, the maximum is some thousand, let's say 1,500 dead, which is about 1,000th of 1,500,000. You cannot turn the issue around to this extent. This is one side of the story, but it seems to me that even more serious is that the Turkish people, who bear no responsibility whatsoever for what happened, and it should be stated that the whole of this debate is directed at government level, and Turkish officials or soldiers, but the Turkish population knows nothing and is not informed. And according to a circular dated 2004, or maybe 2003, students in Turkish schools are asked to talk about the question of pseudo-Armenian genocide. They are initiated, they are being taught revisionism.
En quelque sorte, on les enseigne au négationnisme.